Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. A research proposal describes what you will investigate, why it's important, and how you will do the research. The format of a research proposal varies between fields. First, we need to understand. What is research proposal? A research proposal is a document proposing a research project, generally in the sciences or academia, and generally constitutes a request for sponsorship of that research. Proposals are evaluated on the cost and potential impact of the proposed research, and on the soundness of the proposed plan for carrying it out. Research proposal aims to reflect relevance. Convince the reader that your project is interesting, original, and important. Context. Show that you are familiar with the field, you understand the current state of research on the topic, and your ideas have a strong academic basis. Approach. Make a case for your methodology, showing that you have carefully thought about the data, tools, and procedures you will need to conduct the research. Feasibility. Confirm that the project is possible within the practical constraints of the program, institution, or funding. Most proposals should contain at least these elements. Title page. Introduction. Literature review. Research design. Reference list. This tutorial takes you through a basic research proposal template and explains what you need to include in each part. Title page. Like your dissertation or thesis, the proposal will usually have a title page that includes the proposed title of your project, your name, your supervisor's name, the institution and department. Check with the department or funding body to see if there are any specific formatting requirements. Introduction. The first part of your proposal is the initial pitch for your project, so make sure it succinctly explains what you want to do and why. It should introduce the topic, give background and context, outline your problem statement and research questions. Some important questions to guide your introduction include: who has an interest in the topic, for example? Practitioners, policymakers, particular members of society. How much is already known about the problem? What is missing from current knowledge? What new insights will your research contribute? Why is this research worth doing? Literature review. It's important to show that you're familiar with the most important research on your topic. A strong literature review convinces the reader that your project has a solid foundation in existing knowledge or theory. It also shows that you're not simply repeating what other people have already done or said. In this section, aim to demonstrate exactly how your project will contribute to conversations in the field. Compare and contrast. What are the main theories, methods, debates, and controversies? Be critical. What are the strengths and weaknesses of different approaches? Show how your research fits in. How will you build on, challenge, or synthesize the work of others? Research design and methods. Following the literature review, it's a good idea to restate your main objectives, bringing the focus back to your own project. The research design or methodology section should describe the overall approach and practical steps you will take to answer your research questions. Methodology in a research proposal. Research type: will you do qualitative or quantitative research? Will you collect original data or work with primary or secondary sources? Is your research design descriptive, correlational, or experimental? Population and sample. Exactly what or who will you study, for example? High school students in New York. Scottish Newspaper Archives 1976-80. How will you select subjects or sources, for example? Random sampling, case studies. When and where will you collect the data? Research methods. What tools and procedures will you use, for example? Surveys, interviews, observations, experiments, to collect and analyze data. Why are these the best methods to answer your research questions? Practicalities. How much time will you need to collect the data? How will you gain access to participants or sources? Do you foresee any potential obstacles, and how will you address them? Implications and contribution to knowledge. To finish your proposal on a strong note, you can explore the potential implications of the research for theory or practice, and emphasize again what you aim to contribute to existing knowledge on the topic. For example, your results might have implications for improving processes in a specific location or field, informing policy objectives, strengthening a theory or model, challenging popular or scientific assumptions, creating a basis for further research. Reference list or bibliography. Your research proposal must include proper citations for every source you have used, and full publication details should always be included in the reference list. Research schedule. In some cases, you might have to include a detailed timeline of the project, explaining exactly what you will do at each stage and how long it will take. Check the requirements of your program or funding body to see if this is required. Example Research Schedule 1. Background Research and Literature Review. Meet with supervisor for initial discussion. Conduct a more extensive review of relevant literature. Refine the research questions. Develop a theoretical framework. Revisions and proofreading. As in any other piece of academic writing, it's essential to redraft, edit and proofread your research proposal before you submit it. If you have the opportunity, ask a supervisor or colleague for feedback.
Thank you for watching. I hope you can easily understand that how to write research proposal. Like, share and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.